guys, here we are back on Westbridge. In gain my sea tender. So just currently working on that. So what we're gonna do is we will come down here to well, we own one of those already. Here it is. Meridian, 400 SLD, it's a 650 bushel hopper I put on it, 34 foot gooseneck trailer. Now my pricing's low, I should be about 29,000. So, seed and fertilizer. Go ahead and buy it. And we'll just reset it to the farm here. Voila. There it is. And then we'll reset our planter as well. Go ahead and attach our DB planter. Hop in our Silverado. So I'm really happy with how this whole sea tender turned out. So right off the bat, we'll go pull our ladder, remove our top, come over to the right control. We can move our hitch up and down to adjust for different size vehicles. We can move our auger out. Got running lights, blinkers, brake lights. So this main boom goes with mouse controller keyboard. Then you can also swivel this, and I have it so the you can see the hose swivels. You should probably be able to see it better over here. That main hose, that hydraulic hose, will actually follow. So that's a nice little feature. Then you can also angle this and tip it however you like, to basically self-fill, if you want to do that. So you can self-fill and then we'll just raise this up again. Thank you. turned out pretty nice. I like it. It's pretty fun to play with now that it's all mouse controlled. Another nice feature that you'll see when I drive over to the planter that it automatically fills the cedar when I put the auger over it. So that's another nice feature, is you don't really have to leave the truck. Neither does the guy that's operating the tractor or the planter. So nice little feature there. Slowly filling up our tender. This is spec'd at 34 foot. Put up our ladder here. 34 foot, 650 bushel hopper, which leaves us about 1,000 short. It does have a pipe function that you can just press zero. That's something you'd like to do. Or you could just manually move it with the mouse control. And then, but the way I understand it, the way the overloading strip, you need to actually unload, open up the pipe first. And then, it will begin to unload. So you can see it automatically unloads now. So that's a nice little feature. You can see my Challenger's filling up with seed. We got the fill sound going. Particle animation. Never have to leave the truck. Technically, this should be more like over here. There we go. Put the actual hopper underneath. And you can see we're using up quite a bit of seed. And then we'll just press O to close it back up. And our seed is good. We can go run off and cruise around wherever else we're needed. I really like how it handles. It handles quite a bit better. It puts a lot of the weight over the axle as compared to the rear hitch of the Rockwell JM. Then also, if you want, you can raise or lower this hitch to kind of distribute a little bit of weight differently, I guess. You have to play around with it. What you like the best, or you know, you can always putz around with the auger in the back like this. It can just pretty much basically you just unfold it, keep the pipe unfolded, and then use your mouse control to kind of do it like this if you want. That way you can just back right up to the planter and it'll unload. So the pipe's currently unfolded, but with the mouse control you can still move the auger. So it's a pretty sweet rig. I really like it. I was never really big into the seat tenders, but then on the server we're doing a lot of planning now, and it's pretty difficult to drive around with that JM. This looks pretty nice now, and wanted something with a little bit more playability with the mouse control. Finally have that. It was a quick build, took me like 2 days. You know, it's a pretty simple machine. A little bit different scripting. I'm not used to scripting all the mouse control and all the different refill triggers and stuff like that. But they're not nice. I like the texturing on it. It's not the most detailed mod in the world, but it's definitely detailed enough for a seat tender. Works great, have extra capacity, it's pretty fun to fill. A lot more convenient now that I don't actually have to leave the truck or the tractor to refill. Or someone's already in the tractor, it wasn't a big deal anyways, but I can just putz on over, put the unload auger right over the hopper, and it will fill up no problem. So we got running lights as well. Frame looks pretty nice. I'm really a big fan of gooseneck type trailers. I just think they're a little bit more appealing and they make more sense to distribute the weight over the center of the axle. A little bit better handling. We have a 3500, so might as well get something that this truck can handle. Even with all this weight, it handles it pretty well. It's like 23,000 liters or 22.6 or something like that. And the truck seems to handle it very well, even at higher speeds. I'd say anything over 60, you're starting to flirt with a little bit of uncertainty, but 60 and below, 55 handles it. Great control over driving, so. So yeah, can't wait to start using this on the server. This truck also has the new version 2 passenger script in it from the original author, so we can have more than one passenger. We actually have 3 seats with passengers in here, which works really good. I watched a video the other day on the server, we're kind of up to some shenanigans, so it's nice that we can all hop in the truck and drive around the map together. That is the new LBJ Meridian 400 SLD sea tender. So thanks for watching.